So in this topic, high frequency transistor circuits, part one. So we are going to discuss about different current gains offered by the transistor at high frequency. So we are going to discuss about the different current gains which are offered by the transistor. So here we are going to discuss about common emitter short circuit current gain. So here consider a single stage CE transistor amplifier with load resistance RL as shown in the figure. So this is the single stage CE transistor at high frequency. So here we have considered RL as the load resistance as shown in the figure. So remaining all are the hybrid pi model circuit. So here RBB dash, RB dash E, RB dash E are the hybrid high frequency model components which are already we have drawn in the previous sessions of high frequency model of a transistor. Here we have considered common emitter configuration. So here for the analysis of short circuit current gain, assume RL is equals to 0. So if RL is equals to 0, then RC is going to be eliminated. So for the simplified analysis of short circuit current gain, we have consumed that RL is equals to 0. If RL is equals to 0, then because RL is in parallel with RC, so RC can be eliminated. So here because of RL is equals to 0, RB dash C comma CC comma CE comes in parallel, and here RB dash C so far rather than RB dash E, so RB dash C can be neglected. Then the circuit becomes, so by considering the above all approximations, the finally the circuit becomes like this. So capacitance will be parallel capacitance, so CC plus CE, and we are left with remaining all components. So this is the required circuit by assuming the above considerations. Here Z is the parallel combination of RB dash E and CC plus CE. So here Z can be represented as RB dash E in parallel with 1 by J omega capacitance R in parallel. So finally the expression for Z becomes, so if you solve this one, the expression will be RB dash E by 1 plus J omega into RB dash E into CC plus CE. So this is the expression for impedance Z. Therefore, from circuit, VB dash E can be represented as Z into IB. So from this, impedance Z can be represented as VB dash E by IB. And we know that current gain can be represented as current gain AI equal to IL by IB. So here IL is nothing but what? Minus IC by IB. So here minus IC is nothing but what? Minus GM VB dash E by IB. But VB dash E by IB is nothing but what? Impedance Z. So AI can be represented as minus GM into, therefore current gain A is equals to minus GM into Z is nothing but we have already calculated RB dash E by 1 plus J omega into RB dash E into CE plus CC. But we know that minus GM into RB dash E is nothing but what? HFE. So minus HFE by 1 plus J omega RB dash E into CA plus CC. So this is the expression for current gain of the given circuit. So here from this expression, what we can say is current gain is the function of frequency. So if we draw the graph between current gain and frequency, if the frequency increases, the current gain is going to be decreases. So at f is equals to f beta, at f is equals to f beta, the gain becomes hf by root 2. So this is the expression for f beta. Here f beta is nothing but f beta is equals to 1 by 2 pi rb dash e into ce plus cc. So this is the expression for frequency at which the gain becomes hf by root 2. So the frequency at which short circuit current gain drops to 3 dB or 1 by root 2 times from its value at low frequency is called as F beta. So here F beta can be written as F beta equals to 1 by 2 pi RB dash E into CE plus CC. Here 1 by RB dash E, which is equals to GB dash E, so implies F beta can be written as, so F beta equals to GB dash E by 2 pi into CE plus CC, but GB dash E is nothing but what? GM by HFE by CE plus CC. So this is the final expression for F beta. So parameter F alpha, it is defined as the frequency at which the transistor common base current gain becomes 3 dB or 1 by root 2 times from its value at low frequency. Therefore the current gain of CB configuration is current gain AI equals to minus HFB by 1 plus J into F by F alpha. Therefore here F alpha can be represented 1 by 2 pi RB dash E into CC plus CE. Therefore the current becomes, so modulus of HI can be written as HFB by root over 1 plus F by F alpha whole square. Yet F is equals to F alpha, the gain becomes 1 by root 2 times of current gain HFB. So this is defined as the parameter F alpha. So at frequency F is equals F alpha, gain becomes 1 by root 2 times of its value at low frequency. So parameter FT, it is defined as the frequency at which short circuit CE current gain becomes unity. So the general expression for the current gain is HFE by 1 plus square root of 1 plus F by F beta whole square. So at F is equal to F beta, gain becomes 1. Therefore gain becomes 1 is nothing but, so 1 is equal to gain becomes 1. So square root of 1 plus F by FT by F beta whole square. Here the ratio FT by FT is so far greater than 1, so implies the expression becomes 1 is equals HFE by FT by F beta, implies FT can be written as HFE into F beta. But F beta equals to GM by HFE into CE plus CC into 2 by, so substitute the F beta value in the given expressions, then FT becomes GM by 2 pi into CE plus CC. So this is the expression for FT the gain becomes unity. So Here the another important thing is CE is so far greater than CC. Therefore FT is equals to GM by 2 pi into C. So this is the final expression for FT.